The SST dev command brings up your app in dev mode, but what is it doing behind the scenes? And why are you not supposed to run dev and deploy on the same stage? In this video, we'll look at the details of the SST dev command and how it uses a multiplexer to bring up your functions, your front ends, your backend services in a single unified interface. As an example, I'm going to use a simple SST monorepo app. This is from the standard monorepo template that we have. In the packages directory, there are your functions. I added a front end. This is a Next.js app. I also added a backend service. This is an Express app. Finally, I have a RDS Postgres database that's linked to my functions, my front ends, and my backend service. I have these different parts because I want to show what SST dev does for all these cases. So to start, let's run SST dev. The SST dev CLI is a multiplexer in that it starts all these different processes in the sidebar here. You can see the different parts of my app at the same time. Let's start with our functions. I have a simple function here. It's just printing out the RDS database that it's linked to. SST dev runs your functions in live mode. This is where it deploys a proxy version of your function that proxies requests down to your local machine, runs it locally, and then sends the results back. This allows you to make changes to your functions and to see them instantly. So if I make a quick change here, you'll see it reflected right away. Now, because these functions are running locally, it means that if I go ahead and stop SST dev, your functions won't run either. It shows here that SST dev is not running. And that is a critical bit. We'll come back to that later. But next, let's look at your front ends. We're using Next.js here, but all front ends come with their own dev modes. And so what SST does is it starts up Next.js locally as a part of the multiplexer. So if I head over to localhost 3000, it has access to the linked resources. But because this is running in dev mode and it's not been deployed, SST skips some of the resources that it would normally create. For example, if you deploy your Next.js app with serverless and SST, it creates like a CDN using CloudFront. It creates a bunch of S3 buckets. In this case, it isn't doing any of that. In fact, we don't even have a deployment URL. We just have the local host. Now, if we switch over to the backend, it's a similar idea. We've got Express running locally on localhost 80. It has access to our linked resources. And just like the Next.js case, it skips deploying a bunch of the resources like it normally would because it's running locally. And again, we just have the localhost URL. We don't have a deployed URL either. Before we wrap up here, you might have noticed the tunnel tab. Now, this is a process that SST starts up that allows your local machine to access resources that are in your VPC if you have the bastion option turned on. A VPC is a virtual private network that's in AWS that keeps resources like your Postgres database in this case secure and isolated from the public internet. And what the tunnel is letting you do is it's letting your local machine connect to those resources by creating a tunnel to it. So this means that your Express app that's running locally, or your Next.js app, or your functions that are running locally have access to those resources. Okay, so that's SST dev in a nutshell. It brings up this multiplexer that starts the different parts of your app in dev mode in a single CLI interface. But the thing to remember is that all of your different parts of the functions, the front ends, or your backend services, they're running in dev mode, which is a little bit different from when they're actually deployed. So if you were to run SST deploy, it would create the real versions of these resources, but on the next SST dev, it would flip them back or it would tear them down, which is why we recommend not running SST dev and SST deploy on the same stage. Instead, you run SST deploy. You can use any stage here. I'm going to use prod. And if you give that a second, it'll deploy the real version of your app with all the deployed URLs. So for my Next.js app, it has a URL. My backend API also gets one as well. And the same for my functions. They're now deployed to AWS. Hopefully that gives you an idea of how SST dev works and why you shouldn't use dev and deploy on the same stage.